In this problem, we're given a new data structure that is a list of universities, where each entry is another list that contains the name of the university, the number of students that attend that university, and the tuition cost. And what we want to calculate are the total number of students enrolled at all the universities in this list, and the amount of money that all of them are paying. What we're going to do is sum the number of students, so we're going to keep a track of all the students and keep adding for each university this second value on the list. And then we're also going to keep a second counter. That is the amount of tuition that they're paying. And so what we're going to do for each entry, we're going to multiply these two values and add those. So we're going to have 50 times 2, which is 100, and 100 times 1, which is also 100. So the end result would be the tuition is 200, and the number of students enrolled is 150. So this is what will return both those values. Let's write the function that does that. So I've declared the function. It takes in a list. And I've started my two sums, the number of students enrolled and the total tuition all of the students are paying. So I've added a little trick here to make the code a little shorter. This is a Python thing that you probably didn't know, but feel free to use it in the future. What I'm saying is that for each value in the list, I have the name, which is going to correspond to the first entry in the sublist, the students correspond to the second entry in the sublist, and price corresponds to the third entry in the sublist. If I had the other version, where I just say for I and P and then assign the variables names, that's all we're doing here. Is it just a little shortcut to save you this time of writing the three lines to write this out. So here, for each school, I update the number of students by simply adding the number of students to the total count. And I update the total tuition by simply adding the amount of the students are paying at this particular university to the total tuition. And in the end, I return both values, which you can do by simply adding the comma.